Mini Chapter 41, The Infinity Pool at the Blue Jay Way House. Except for the diminutive offshoot of Hopen Place halfway up it, Blue Jay Way is a single winding strip leading to a cul-de-sac. Within walking distance of the very top, Amber parks in a discreet curve in the road. He gets out, locks the car, and slips into a narrow space of vegetation between houses. He pushes through undergrowth, down a slope, towards the hollow of the canyon beyond the rear boundaries of these properties, and turns to face the grand mansion positioned up behind the fence on his left. He looks around, calculating his options. Then he scales a tree, clambers along a branch, and drops down on the other side of the fence. Up a slope of earth beside one wing of the house, he stops behind a bank of foliage enclosing the back terrace. He and Jaymi peer through the leaves. And there is Dud, just 10 meters away, beside an infinity pool whose further side seems to merge, with hardly a break, into the blue sky over the cityscape beyond. Along another side of the pool, adjacent to the hillside, stands a line of 5 unlit tiki torches, the lantern holder of each torch being emblazoned with the logo of a different one of Ain’tTheyFreaky's 5 newsfeeds. Lounging in a deck chair, Dud is intent on his computer. Perhaps he's busy this very minute in big entrepreneurial dreams for Bangdad's Guy Score Hunk or Gross newsfeed. Or perhaps his smug assiduousness is engaged in hatching some other future newsfeed. Somehow, this matter-of-fact new view of him as being just a man sitting outside his home reveals to Jaymi with greater clarity the dreary mean-mindedness in Dud's using his energies to create something as ugly as Ain’tTheyFreaky. Stationed here, looking through the leaves at him, Amber feels deliriously alone. How sweet it would be to step into the world of that monkey there during the next few seconds and snip through its neck with a powerful blade. He's aware of just the velocity that would be necessary. He can also imagine the kind of physical vibrations that would be transmitted from the blade's handle into his own hands and blonde-haired arms as a result of the blade's encounter with what they'd be severing inside the neck. How easy that would be, how right, and how restful. Amber has not come for that, however. Today he's been tasked with a gentle reconnoitre of weak points in Dud's inhabitation of the world, plus a little terrorisation. But with such a clear sight as he now possesses, Amber perceives that pretty much all of Dud's inhabitation of the world is weak. How flimsy, in flesh-bound reality, are all the walls that this vile little monkey relies on, walls of law, security, money, status. How paper-thin those walls are in Amber's and Jamie's sight.